D3. I want to unpack that name a bit because I think it speaks to why the library was created and how it integrates data with a web page. Data-driven documents. Data, in this case, refers to some information we are trying to visualize, be it CSV or a JSON loaded externally, or simply a JavaScript object or variables. Documents is a reference to a web page or web document, rather a collection of HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and SVG often. But hey, data-driven HTML, or data-driven pages, just didn't have the same ring to it. And driven, D3 binds data to the document, or rather, more concretely, rows of a CSV or JSON to SVG elements. More formally, documents doesn't only refer to the source of the page and the content of the HTML, CSS, JavaScript, or SVG, but it could also refer to what's called the Document Object Model, or DOM. Web browsers can be thought to store two versions of the web page, or rather, two views, one of which is the initial source, as I mentioned, that gets returned from the web server, and the other is a parsed DOM object. The Document Object Model is a specification, much like HTML and CSS, that specifies a common programming interface for HTML and XML documents. Once the source of the HTML is returned from the server, the web browser parses the file and transforms it into a hierarchical object that can be accessed programmatically, most often through JavaScript, called the DOM. D3 actually binds data to the DOM rather than the source or visual elements of the HTML. But since the DOM actually represents and can interact with what's displayed visually, when we bind data to the DOM, D3 drives the document, in this case the visual representation of the DOM, and creates a chart based on the data that's in the DOM.